A stunning view. It reminds me of my early years in Norway. How I used to climb the hills beyond the wood.
You have an adventurous heart. I hardly see it behind the table, but now I've watched you scale a tower in furs, soaking wet.
I was rowdy in my youth. Hunting, sailing. I was a wildling of the open air before I became this staunch and stoic woman. Married off in service of peace between two clans. A noble and worthy role, but not one I had ever imagined for myself.
You would have made a fine wandering warrior. A Jomsvikinger, free to come and go as she pleased.
I think so too. It may be we would have sailed together over the open seas, raiding or traveling.
Or faced each other on the field of battle. Without your marriage to Sigurd to secure peace, our clans might still be at war.
True. Very true. Thank you for today. Every bit of it has been a dream, and I'm not keen to wake.
Then don't. We can stay here as long as you like.
Yes.
What was that?
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have. I got away from myself.
No need to apologize.
Sigurd is your brother, and I have put you in a very difficult position. The heart does not do politics like the head.
It may be the meat, it may be the air, but there's no need to apologize.
I am sober enough. But the truth of it is, I have felt this way for some time now. I care for you, Eivor.
That is comforting to hear. I have long felt the same way. But I banished the thought that this would ever happen.
Many times I wished to tell you. Wished to say what was in my heart and what I desired. But duty kept me from it.
Say all you like.
Today has meant so much. We rode, we fought, we drank, we laughed. You showed me your world. Not in words, but deeds.
Deeds are more direct than words. Andre? Must have returned to the settlement.